Today was a culminating event of months of work between the Syracuse University School of Ed and the OCM BOCES Center for Innovative Teaching and Learning. We've been working for a number of years together, trying to help improve science teaching and learning in our area using a professional development process called Lesson Study.
At OCM BOCES, we provide professional development to teachers in 23 component districts, so lesson study is something we're interested in supporting if our districts want it. We also support an elementary curriculum materials program that is in about 1,500 classrooms in just under 30 districts, and we are in the process of transitioning that to the new science in the classroom materials coming from the Smithsonian Science Education Center. So we're using the curriculum materials and the professional development as a way to embed the new standards in classrooms in Central New York.
Today I worked with 12 fourth grade students, and our focus question was, how do profiles of landforms relate to topographic maps? So students took 3D models of different landforms of different mountains around the United States, and they matched up the landform to the topographic map using contour lines, elevation, shapes of the models to match it up to the topographic map. Then what they did is then they made a profile using a piece of paper and a flashlight. So they took that profile and then they used that information to then also match up the topographic map so they can see the connections between all of these different representations for landforms.
My teaching has changed a great deal with the Smithsonian kits. Before it was very teacher-led, vocabulary-oriented, reading, doing things as a whole. And here there's a lot of group work, a lot of hands-on, a lot of try it, see what happens kind of a thing. And so certainly because of that, my teaching has had to change. And so the atmosphere is much different. It's not the quiet classroom we're used to. It's a lot of noise, a lot of bustle, a lot of learning going on by all rather than maybe just a few.
I think the culture shift is how excited the kids are when they use these materials. The level of engagement and excitability for all students.
So today's work is meant to help invite other members of the local community into the lesson study process. It's meant to highlight how we can teach science so that all children can have the high quality opportunities to learn.
Today is also about bringing together the professionals to have professional discourse on what does equity and access mean, and specifically what does that mean in the science classroom.
I think one of the most critical components today was actually brought up by Terrence in his closing comments.
Is thinking about how shared knowledge has been created in these spaces and how everyone has been a part of the knowledge that's been created. And that knowledge that's been created is not any less valid than what is printed inside of a textbook for students to read.
That's one of the critical reasons that we do this work, why we try to make teaching so public.
I'd say having shared experiences, such as engaging in lesson study, is critical for us to have a shared understanding, because we often have very different meanings when we say one word. You know, what does it mean X for students to do? But when we have shared experiences, we can then develop professional shared understandings.
Why should families care about what we do in lesson study? Because it's a very public way of demonstrating to our whole community, one, the hard work that teaching is, two, the dedication that teachers have to the profession, to each other, and especially to our children, and allows parents a way to see in to the hard work that they don't often get to see, because usually what they get to see is what comes home in their children's backpack. And that is a tiny representation of all that goes on at school. And so lesson study provides parents potentially with a way to see how is teaching really unfolding in their school and what kind of impact are those lessons having on their kids.